The Eternal Quest, in association with Ahmedabad Book Club, American Corner, Ahmedabad and Hello Gujarat TV presents a weekend conversation with author Chetna Bhatia, a teacher, an art lover and also nature lover, born and brought up in Jamnagar, Gujarat, now settled in Mumbai, is into education as well as training kids for dance and drama from the past 30 years. Her teaching profession developed a passion for writing in her. She has contributed several poems, quotes, and stories to around 30 national and international anthologies. Most of her poems are about love and nature. She writes in three different languages, English, Hindi, and Gujarati. She also has her own quote book, which was Valentine's Day special, Unspoken Feelings, which was a bestseller on Amazon. We welcome you on Eternal Quest, ma'am.
Thank you so much.
Ma'am, as we know that your introduction says a lot about, you know, your achievements, your success. So can you tell us more about your journey towards success and what inspired you the most?
Okay, to start with, I've been writing for students till now. So one fine day, I just thought of writing for myself. And I came across an app called Your Quote. So my first quote for a special was like from Your Quote, and since then the journey has started, and I really owe it to Your Quote, which has given me a flight, and my journey has really been successful after that. So that's how I started writing. I've written quite a few like plays and poems and all that. That was all for student essays and all that, just to help them. But then writing actually started just maybe 4 years back. So that's how it is.
It was good that you started doing for yourself, ma'am. And it really turned out to be good.
I never thought I would write, like I would go into writing, but then... yes, it gave me a flight and I'm happy about it.
I'm coming to your book, ma'am. The title and cover page of the book, Unspoken Feelings, it looks very interesting. Can you tell us more about it?
Yeah, sure. I would like to show that book because it's very close to my heart. It's a small, cute little book. Yeah. And especially as you said, it was a Valentine's Day special. So it has two-liners, four-liners, love quotes in it, which is like, if somebody gives you chocolates or maybe flowers or something, it stays for a day or a week at the most. So this book was designed in such a way that it has all the feelings, especially for the people who are who fall short of words. Like they do feel for their love, but they don't know how to express. So the quotes which are here, anybody can read it for their love. The quotes are such. So maybe you've gone for a romantic candlelight dinner or you're having some alone time. You can just read these quotes to your love and you'll feel, oh yeah, I really wanted to say this. So the quotes are written in such a way,
and like words stays with you forever. So yes, definitely yes. This will stay,
you can forever. Cherish it at your old age also. You can say, okay, this is something that I had received.
Yeah,
so that was the main intention, like, and it was specially targeted, like since it's Valentine's Day, the main aim was to go for college students. Mostly the college students would go for it. So it was also kept pocket friendly, not very high price. So it was really a main target that college friends can use it as well.
It is a great idea, ma'am. And what are the various themes covered in Unspoken Feelings?
It just says it all. It's just about feelings that you want to tell your love or your partner, whatever. So it's just something that you would want to tell your love. That's it. So it's only about feelings.
Yeah. It's like pouring your heart out through words.
True, yeah. It's just about that.
Ma'am, while writing this book or while writing any of your poems, stories, essays, do you face any writer's block and how do you overcome it?
Yes, at times it is like blank or something, like you don't want to write anything. I mean, nothing comes to your mind. So at that time, you feel like just pouring out whatever is coming into your mind. Maybe it's a rough thing. Maybe you're feeling sad. Maybe you're feeling negative. But still, something is there in your mind. Just pour it out and maybe it turns out to be something good. So whatever is there in your mind, it's on paper. So, yes, but I have made, like I have given a promise to myself. Every day I'm going to write something. If not much, of two-liner, or four-liner, or six-liner. But yes, not a single day should go without writing. A simple two-liner is also fine, but yes. So that keeps me going and keeps me telling, yes, you have to write. So it keeps me. And yes, I can also say that your quote app, which gives you prompts. So whenever at times you don't have anything, those prompts help you to push yourself. So that is also a fantastic platform for new writers. So that has also helped me to go.
Yeah, like it should be a daily habit. And I personally know about your quote because I've used it as well. It is okay, a great platform, right. Like you said.
Yes. So that is something, the day I miss out on writing and like I'm already on bed. I have not written something. So let me do that task and then go to sleep. So that keeps me going all the time.
So, ma'am, can you read your favorite lines from the book?
True. I would read 2-3 special ones. Like every quote says something really good, but you are the reason why I want to live 100 years. I don't have any reason, but yes, I love you. So you don't have a reason, but yeah. You know what I love about you? The whole of you. Wow. So these are the small quotes which like tells everything about you. Yeah. In love, it's never when or why. It just happens without a reason. Wow. So I've written these small two-liners in this book.
Yeah, these are very sweet and, you know, like it directly hits your heart. It is amazing.
Yeah, thank you.
And ma'am, we also know that you write, you know, three different languages, English, Gujarati and Hindi, and you write in all three of them. So with composition in different languages, which one is more close to your heart and why?
Though I started writing in English, till now I've been writing in English. Once a publisher approached me for Gujarati anthology, and he proposed me like, why don't you take over Gujarati anthology? That time it came to my mind like, oh my God, that's my mother tongue and I've not written anything in Gujarati for a long time. Like I'm away from the script from a long, long time. Like after settling in Mumbai, I just lost touch with Gujarati script. Yeah, talking happens with the family, but the script was like not in touch. So I did hesitate initially, but then I said, no, that's my mother tongue and I have to get back to it. So that's how I started the first anthology with Gujarati. And I would say that was my first kid. So, like, very close to my heart. I named it Avsar. And we had quite a few new writers, like, first time they were getting published. So, really very excited with that book. And that's how we started with Gujarati anthology. And now I am totally with Gujarati, though I write English and Hindi. But yes, Gujarati is really close to my heart.
And like our mother tongue stays with us through birth up to till death, you know, so it is always special.
Yes. True.
Your future publications on Gujarati anthologies also have very interesting themes, so we would like to know about that.
Right now, I'm working with two topics. One is Parivartan. That came to our mind like there are lots of changes we've been seeing since Corona has entered our life and it has taken a big thing. So we see lots of changes in ourselves, in our routine, in people around. So lots and lots of changes. It has totally changed mindset of people, how you live, towards life, so many things. So that's how we came up with Parivartan, and we are writing regarding Parivartan. So yes, we've got really good scripts on that, and I'm just waiting to get it published very soon.
Like you said, you know, everything just changed 360 degrees since Corona came, so I'm sure it would be very interesting to read it.
Writers have come up with beautiful things, like never thought of when something will come up, but now I have started editing and compiling. When I'm reading, it has really touched my heart. Very beautiful thing.
And like now we are talking about writing, ma'am. So we know that you write poetry as well, and it is one of your passions. So what is poetry and passion according to you?
Poetry, I would say, it tells you a lot, but you should have love for it, or you should try to get connected to it. So only if you have that feelings for the poetry, or if you have that touch with the poetry, you will understand a lot. Even if it is a four-liner, it will tell you a lot, and you can understand a lot from that. So that depends on a reader too. How are you reading it? Are you just reading it for the heck of it, or are you really taking the meaning of it? So it tells you a lot, though it is a two-liner or a four-liner.
And any tips that you would like to give to our aspiring writers?
Yes, I would say writers nowadays do write, but they don't get a good platform. Sometimes it happens, there are really good writers, but they are just lost in the crowd. Or sometimes it is taken like there's no money, or there's no financial support or something for writing. So they just keep it aside. So I would say writers, not to leave your passion. Whatever career you are into, whatever responsibilities you are carrying or something. But if you have that in you, please don't leave it. Somewhere, someday it is going to shine you somewhere. So keep writing, keep growing. If not a published writer, like if you don't get the name like a Chetan Bhagat or Amish or something, it's okay. But at least it is giving you a flow to pour out your emotions, your feelings. There are times when, you cannot tell something to someone. It is just buried inside you. But if you have this habit of writing, it just gives you a pour out. And it is out of your system, whether it is good or bad. At times we say, okay, there is something good happening, but we should not be telling it to someone. Nazar lag jayegi. Yeah, people do believe. So at least pour it out. Otherwise, it is going to hammer your mind all the time. Whatever it is, good or bad, just pour it out. So have that habit of writing it, whether you write a diary, whether you write a poem, whether you write a story, whatever you write, give a flow or give a pour out to your feelings. So don't stop writing if you have it in you.
Like, we should never give up on our passion. That's the key. Right. And ma'am, we are very keen to know that what are your future plans now, and what will we see more? What is there in it for us?
My future plans, if I say yes, I will go ahead with the anthologies. I will be making more anthologies because I know anthologies are not sold much. Like people don't prefer buying anthologies because the cost of it is also equal to a good writer's storybook. Like if you go to compare, if you see the market. But it is giving a confidence, it is giving a platform to new writers. So that's the reason I've been doing anthologies, and this is my sixth anthology I'm doing. It is just to give a base to good writers or whoever feels like writing, whoever has started writing. So this is just a first step for them. Once they step on it, they may get a flight. So yes, I will continue with the anthologies, just giving a support to new writers.
That is great, ma'am. It would really be an inspiration for the aspiring writers.
Yes, I would like to support them.
Yeah. Besides writing, ma'am, we know that art and nature and love, you are very passionate about that as well. So do these themes find a place in your poetry?
Yes, most of my writings are for love or life. And the nature is like into me. Like I want to spend my last days in the lap of nature. So maybe if destiny calls, it will happen. And there I will get more time to write. So that's how it's connected, nature and writing.
That is great, ma'am. And any message that you would like to give to your readers?
Yes, definitely. That is something I would tell the readers is, as I just said it before, when you check the rates of the book, you see the well-known writers, the book cost of that person is, say, around 200, 250 or something. And the new writers, their cost also may be similar somewhere. So definitely you are going to pick up a known writer. Right. So I would tell the readers, if you don't give chance to a new writer, how will he become a known writer, right? So please, it's a request to the readers. Well-known writers are already established. Give them a chance to show their talent, show what they have in them. So don't hesitate if you find a good theme or a good topic on a new writer's cover. Please pick it up and give them a chance. At least try to know what do they have. Maybe in a year or so, you will find them in a rack of a known writer.
Yeah.
So I would want to tell readers to give new writers a chance, maybe an anthology. It is just a support to new writers or new publication. So do support them.
What you said is so true, ma'am, because I personally, when I go for reading, I choose the, you know, books from a well-known writer or the writer who is very famous because, you know,
we know that it will be a good story only, and we know their form of writing.
Yeah.
But till you don't read a new writer, how will you know what, maybe he is better than the other one?
Yeah, so that is so true, ma'am.
Yeah, so that's what I wanted to say. Readers, please give them a chance. Give it a try. It's like, of course, it won't be a 500 or 1,000 rupees copy. It will be just a minimum cost of 200, 250 or something. I think we can support them.
Yeah.
Otherwise, the literature is really going to die. Like if you go to see, as it is, the readers are decreasing. Because we know people don't want to read. Now the YouTube and Instagram and WhatsApp has taken over so much that people have just forgotten reading. I wouldn't, I will say, even for me, the reading time has become too less. Even writing time, like since we are into the other social media, the time is eaten up by that. So if we don't support, the literature is really going to die, whatever language it is or whatever it is. But we need to support the writers.
Yeah, And moreover, people now prefer reading on social networking sites and everything. Like, manual reading is getting lost somewhere.
Yeah. It's just disappearing.
Yeah. So that was a great message, ma'am. And we would like to end our session with a quick rapid fire round. So we can start when you are ready, ma'am.
Sure.
Okay. So you have to pick, ma'am, nature or love?
Love for nature.
Wow, that is very sweet. And your favorite place to travel?
I want to see India. Like, our country has such beautiful places. So, yes, north, mountains are close to my heart. And desert too. So, yes, I would want to travel and see nook and corner of India first.
Yeah, like India truly has one of the best destinations in the world.
Beautiful, beautiful places. But people don't value it.
Yeah. Your favorite color and why?
My favorite color is red. Like, it has been from childhood. Every birthday I used to get a red frock. So in school, my teachers also used to wait. Like, they knew it's her birthday. So she's going to come in red. And like, I was named Red Riding Hood by my teachers and friends. So I still have that close to my heart.
Next is North Indian or South Indian cuisine?
South Indian, because my mom is from Hyderabad, so I've been having South Indian a lot. So yeah, I relish South Indian a lot.
The last is, if you were to write an autobiography about you, what would be the title of the book?
I would say my actual journey of life, which I feel is after I started writing. So I would say journey with words.
Yeah, that is truly very appropriate for you, ma'am. Yeah. So it was a great session with you, ma'am. And we wish you all the best for all your future endeavors. And we can't wait to read more from you.
Thank you so much. It was nice being with you here.
Thank you, ma'am.